yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Yeah, you got that yummy, yum, that yummy, yum, that yummy, yummy. Say the word on my way. Yeah, babe, yeah, babe.
What's going on, beautiful people? Listen, we're just fixing our plates, okay, and everything like that. So, tips for you know, to the point where what can I do to replace what I love, okay?
I love.
Comment down below, right? Mm-hmm. And so I started, that took a while. The first 3 years was very hard. I gained weight instead of losing weight because I didn't know what to eat, so I was eating a lot of starch, right? But fast forward to today, we have things, we found things we like vegan sausages and stuff like that. This is from Beyond.
I think okay. This is the only product from Beyond that I enjoy.
Okay, we like the burger.
I like Impossible.
Oh, yep, it's Impossible, okay.
Yep, and Impossible.
Beyond burger, I feel like it's too much, like, smoky. It's, like, overpowering sometimes.
You feel like Beyond burger is overpowering?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. There's something in one pasta. It's
like a lot of smokiness, and I'm just
wanting
something very savory. I don't
want to
feel like I'm having a long breathing
phase.
A lot.
So you said that the eggs was bomb, Mr. Man. Like, mm-hmm. He don't even eat eggs. He didn't eat regular eggs. And so if you see it, that's a just egg right there. Shout out to Lynn, okay. Shout out to Lynn Painter, okay, because Lynn was the first person who fixed just eggs for me, and I was like, Lynn, where do I find this? This was like, that was actually back in 2020, and I didn't cook them on my own or even find it on my own until last year, 2021, and so, I love it.
Everybody cheers.
It's made with a mug bean. A lot of people say, well, what's in it? If it's not meat, what's in it? So a lot of things are, you can't eat her sausage? She's trying to eat that girl's sausage. That's how good it is.
No.
Ain't no more, Mom.
You ate all yours.
Ain't no more. It's okay. I have to make you some more later, after the video, okay? No, you can have mine. Don't show off on the camera, the people looking at you. Mm-hmm. Sit down.
No, they watching.
Eat the rest of that and we'll feed you some more later, okay?
Always
want. She is spoiled, y'all. But let me tell you. So for her, it has been a transition. Because her favorite thing, when I was pregnant with her, I was already towards changing my diet, right? So when I had her, I still was eating eggs. I didn't really eat milk like that. I mean, drink milk like that. You know, I was vegetarian. So she already been on this different type of diet from the beginning, you know. So, but her growing up in a family that cooks was difficult. My mama cooked.
Everybody up in the house.
Papa cooked. So it's real hot for her. No problem with my granddaddy.
No, I was just saying.
But yeah. So chicken was her thing. Hot dog was her thing. Turkey was her thing, so it's been kind of difficult. But another thing that was her thing, though, is fruits and vegetables.
That was her main thing.
So, Becky, talk about your experience and how it's been for you.
It's been very challenging.
Okay. What's been the biggest challenge? Becky is 12.
The biggest challenge was.
The biggest challenge was.
To be honest, it was like cutting off my favorite foods, like the pepperoni pizza.
Woo, pepperoni pizza, honey. He couldn't stand when I used to go to the store in the past 4 years, and now I get pizza, and I get cheese. Okay, you gonna eat it or not? Eat it or not, you know what I'm saying?
Whatever. I think the biggest challenge for me, make sure y'all speaking up so that the camera can pick it up.
Because it's way over there.
I think the biggest challenge for me was, well, even I'm not fully vegan nor vegetarian.
Right, she got her own stuff outside the house.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I have enough respect to do that.
And like, she better not bring it in my crib.
Wait, because, hold on.
You be bringing it.
Wait.
Beef jerky. You know
what? I'm saying? What? I never bought beef jerky.
That's beef jerky. Slim Jim.
Hold on, that's the part of the video.
No, I buy them and I eat them.
That's the part of the video house. That's going to go, whoo.
were not vegan, and I
eat them, sis.
You right? But I didn't eat some. But I threw them away.
I tried.
You see, I'm being honest though. I threw them away after the fact. I told you those weren't vegan.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I see you.
I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, he did. Girl, stop.
Stop, mom. You gotta stop. You gotta cut it out.
A lot of the time,
okay, you're going to notice very quickly that this is the boss baby, mm-hmm. and we're going to be fucking with her a lot. Some of our videos you're going to be seeing Zahira, okay, because she is a lot, okay, she has a lot of energy, she is an Aries, and sometimes we want to focus on the show, we want to focus on the meal, we want to focus on what we got going on, and she's not really there, you know, to be able to do that yet, but sometimes we're going to bring her in. So you can have your little one tune in and see how they be acting. Okay. Yeah, so.
Okay. Oh my God, Simon, who was the egg?
I'm like,
yes.
Okay.
I don't know. So.
I know y'all see all of this stuff on the table here, okay? So like I said, these are just a few products that we use. Okay, I put the biscuit box down. A lot of these things still have some soy products in it. As you are on your journey, family, do not let anyone who is on a higher level than you shame you for where you are on your journey. You know, because I started out as vegetarian. Well, first I started cutting red meats out. I haven't eaten pork in 8 years. Okay. And so for 8 years, I was 8 years ago, I started slowly cutting the red meat out of my life. And then 4 years ago is when I went into veganism, okay? And I was still eating dairy, like snacks and regular eggs and stuff like that. And look at me, 4 years later, now I'm like, okay, let me transition it to vegan. And one thing that I'm noticing in the vegan journey is you have to be careful. You have to read the back, right? Because when you go into places, it may have organic, it may have natural, it may have these type of terms in it. But, you know, it's not that. You know, when you flip it over, you'll see all this processed information, the citric acid, the, you know, the overload of soy. So a few of these products here have soy in them. And so soy is next. Soy is next what we are aiming to eliminate out of our diet, okay? We have already become aware of it, that happens. So, it's processed foods, but it's a lot of soy as well, right? And so, you know, in lieu of that, we are going to be starting our own garden as well. So, I've purchased little seeds and stuff. I'm excited.
So, with that being said, let's get back to these chicken tenders, right? Okay. So, the chicken tenders, it was very simple. Because you thought it was cauliflower.
It was coated in cauliflower.
Yeah. It was coated in cauliflower.
So in the front, it said cauliflower, biggest day.
It said cauliflower.
Okay, the point I'm making in this, right? The front is for entertainment. The back is for your education, okay? Remember that. Go ahead.
So Zaki brought it to my attention. Like they were good.
She made them with sauce, bro, and they were good, bro.
Okay.
But
can I send you last sausage?
Mommy said, "What about it?" Okay. So Zaki brought it to my attention that it was real chicken. He said, "Zari, is this chicken breast?" I was like, why was hold on there and look at that. So it's okay. It's like he brought it to my attention that it was real chicken. So I'm looking at it and I look on the back with the information. So it's about this lady who wanted breaded chicken to be healthier. So she coated it in cauliflower.
Which is absolutely stupid. I mean, okay. It worked for her. You know, if it works for you, then it works for you. You know, but whatever, dog. We're not ready to go down that rabbit hole on that whole situation, okay? But what we have found, so those were not vegan, right?
But we have found that it's a chicken replacer, right? Gardein.
Yes.
Gardenia. Is it Gardein or Gardenia? Like I said, we're going to post all of this stuff below, okay? But Gardenia or Gardein, they have some very good plant-based options, okay? But you got to watch them too, all right? You can find Gardenia in Walmart. You can find the food line, Kroger, different stuff like that. But you got to watch them too. Because some of their vegetarian items still have milk and cheese in it, okay? And in the western part of the world, cheese and eggs are not considered, they are considered vegetarian. In other parts of the world, eastern part of the world, is no vegetarian and vegan. It's just vegan, and it's no meat, and it's no dairy, okay? So she can go in there. Oh, never mind. Nope. She's there right there. Okay, cool. So the things that you see here, right? This is mostly what we have in our cabinet, okay? I'm trying to eat mine. I've been talking. I'm here. Okay.
Sausage?
So no, not sharing my sausage. I love the Beyond Meat sausage.
Oh my
God,
they go crazy in the house, bro.
They do not last in our house, okay? And the burgers. I love spicy black bean burgers, but that's another show, okay? This morning, I wanted to introduce you to, if you're a vegetarian, vegan lifestyle journey, chickpeas are going to be your best friend.
Oh, yeah.
You can make a chickpea scramble. You can add this into your hot pom patties that are like a crab cake replacer. You can make hummus out of chickpeas, okay? And we're gonna make chocolate. Yeah, and we're gonna be posting a lot of these recipes on the page too. So make sure that you like, share, subscribe, follow, and support TriVegan TV. And also sometimes recipes are different things that you know, different regular meals that you like, and you're wondering how you can make this a vegan option, a vegan meal. Send it to us. We can figure it out for you, or we'll pass it over to our mama. You know she grandma, my mama.
We got you regardless. Try vegan.
The biggest thing. Okay. You see that? This is a noodle brand
called Koyo.
Okay, so
now let's talk about these noodles for a second.
So with these noodles, they're not like regular ramen. Because, you know, these noodles are vegan. The ramen or the monarch, is that what it's called, monarch?
Yeah.
All that. That's vegetarian because it has milk. That's vegetarian because it has milk in it. But these noodles are vegan. These right here. So with those, they don't necessarily have a lot of flavor. The flavor doesn't really get stuck into the noodles like you feel. You know what I'm saying?
So like you need to put like a couple of spices up in there.
Yeah, you gotta add your little stuff. But I know I can't remember my favorite. I like top ramen.
My favorite one was the seaweed.
I didn't necessarily have a favorite one from that page.
Like, it was the seaweed, and it was this.
So check your noodles, too. Because when my babies found out that they couldn't eat them whole boxes of noodles up in there, I got to them. When you come from where we come from, it's very rare that you hear about a family who don't eat meat, a family who don't eat a certain type of noodles, who even thinking about flipping over a noodle pack and seeing what's in the noodles. You understand what I'm saying? So, we got to change the narrative in our minority communities because we are suffering the most. We have the least access to the best items. But they don't have to be expensive. You know, eating healthy can some people say it's expensive. It can be, but you have to realize that you do not eat the same way. When you're changing, you're eating healthier, you're turning vegan or vegetarian, you are not going to eat the same way that you were eating when you were eating that natural stuff. So it changes full circle. And you just have to take your time and do what's best for you. Don't try to follow everybody else's trends. You know,
it's so many go hard vegans out here, so many go hard herbalists out here, so many go hard, you know, educators out here who shame people for where they are, no matter where you are. If you ain't like them, where they at? Nah. We here to try vegan and encourage you to try vegan as well.
Vegan.
So we can live healthier, stronger lives in minority communities, y'all. We don't gotta be up in the suburbs living like the others just to have a healthy lifestyle now. So we finding the things that work for us, okay? Period.
So
the next
day. So let's talk about
I don't think Howard are gonna be here with us. And y'all should know, if you know me, I am Zabidi Morgan. You can follow me on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, anything that you can find me on it. I am Zabidi Morgan. And you will be able to get in contact with me, y'all. And this is my son, okay? Zaki.
All right. AKA King Dunamis.
Okay. Find him on PlayStation. I think he's banned right now, though.
Yeah, I'm
sensitive talk. It's a sensitive talk. Zaki, let's talk about what your favorite meal has been so far on this vegan journey.
My favorite meals have been breakfast, like some pancakes with, now I'm going to say eggs. Now I can say eggs.
Now you can say, oh, you hadn't tried it before?
No.
What?
Some pancakes. You got to teach me how to make the eggs, too.
Because before you went vegan, right, your favorite food was meat. He's a meat eater, okay? So for him, this was, like, kind of tough for him. But Zaki don't even realize, like, over the past 5 years, he has been the one that was insinuating us not, you know, stop eating animals. I remember he said it, like, 5 years ago. We were sitting at the table, like, whatever, bruh. You know what I'm saying? like, whatever, bruh. Like, but it actually manifested, you know, so King, tell us, breakfast, alright, what about the jackfruit sliders, like, what else?
Those, I like them. Make some jackfruit sliders with some steak fries.
The jackfruit, this is what we use. We get our cans from, I don't know if you can see it good.
Oh,
I'm horrible at this.
Like, what was that?
This is the jackfruit that we use, and you can get it in water or in brine. If we like to get it in water, but if we have to get it in brine, then we just soak it in some spring water for about 30 minutes, if not all night. And, you know, you do it like that. And now I put the recipe to that very soon, so stay connected. But yeah, barbecue jackfruit sandwiches. Anything else?
I don't even know because I don't even be eating like that. But to be totally honest, I only eat breakfast and dinner.
Okay. So you find yourself eating less now too? What about school? I know school is kind of difficult for y'all. Because when we, you know, we started this transition over a break, you know, last year in the fall. And I was like, okay, y'all getting ready to go back to school. Like, what you gonna do when you go to school? You know what I'm saying? So, what was that like in school? What were your friends saying? I know some of them were apprehensive about what you had going on. Talk about that.
Everybody, like, when I bring my rap to school, mm-hmm. Everybody was like, what's that?
Oh, yeah, I was gonna take lunches.
I was like, I'll be getting rap. It was like, my friend Arian, he asked him, he had a piece, so I gave him a piece because, like, we're friends with it.
Right.
And he said it was pretty good.
Okay. So you in there, you about to change lives at school. I'm going to hear about Zariana. Well, maybe we'll be able to get how she feels a little later. What you doing? Get out there.
This is bubbly.
Oh, let her, yeah, you know, you have a lot of people. When I told my grandfather that we were vegan, right, my grandfather is 91 years old now, he raised me on his own. You know, my grandmother passed away when I was three.
Turn it down a little bit.
some of the nana passed away when I was 3, and so my grandfather raised me for a bit of time by himself, and then I started that journey with my mom when I was about 8 years old. So many years have passed since then, y'all, and you know, he has life twirled in such a way that caused him to end up having to live with me at the later days of his life. So I take honor and taking care of him, y'all, but it is no cakewalk, baby, okay? So Papa is also vegetarian. He's also vegetarian, working on vegan, and it works for him. It works for him. It works for him because he already has, you know, current, you know, situations. He has a pacemaker, he has liver damage, he has acid reflux, you know, a number of things. And so, you know, he has been successful on this journey as well. So, I mean, we were just talking about where he was going, like how Zaki transitioned into the vegan lifestyle and how it was with his friends and different things like that. So talk to the people and let them know how you feel. Like, how was the transition for you? What's your favorite vegan meal?
My favorite vegan meal is pasta. Or that rice. You know that rice chicken stuff? That rice chicken and salad stuff I just did? Oh my god. It just be busting, bro. I don't know how I came up with it. I was
be hitting different.
Let me boil some rice. Let me stir up some chicken. And let me stir up this. What's it called? Spinach.
Because this is Junior Chef in the house, y'all.
Okay. And I'm a Junior Chef too.
Okay. Oh, aspirations.
You can't even cook pancakes.
Yes,
I can.
He can cook pancakes. Don't come for that.
Proper.
You couldn't either. Why can't I get it to flat rain? Why would I get to my? I ain't gonna do it like that.
I used to do that.
Yes.
But hold on, babe. I've been cooking so well, I must have forgot.
It does this to your confidence. Tell the people what kind of fruit you like, Mom.
Strawberries.
You do?
Strawberries, pineapple.
I said, Mom.
No, strawberries.
Okay. So what's your favorite vegetable?
Carrots.
Wow. Okay. Do you have anything you want to tell the people about eating good and healthy?
Vegetables.
Tell them something about eating healthy. Is eating healthy good for you? Yes. Would it make your hair continue to grow? Mm-hmm. Yes. Shout out to Miss E.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yes. Hair killer in the house. Come on, everybody come in right quick. Yes.
It's giving volume. It moves.
It's giving black girl. Black boy magic. Melanin be popping. It's giving all that. You know?
All of it.
We also want to come here and share our vegan, because the products that we use are definitely vegan, definitely vegetarian friendly, animal friendly products. So we're going to be coming here throughout the time and showing you just showing you different elements of our lifestyle.
You were supposed to be back here, and I back here.
Well, it's okay, because it looked different in the camera. She can see herself, so she's like. Shout out to Hair Killer, because she got us right last week. We got our trims, okay? Zaki is working on his locks. So he got a little bit of growth. Yeah. Okay, he's working on his locks, so she round them up. She got me clipped and everything, okay? Got my little pin curl, press and curl going on. My baby girl loving her fro. She want to blow out, dun-dun. Ends clip for the first time, okay? Oh, excuse me, sorry.
You should have seen her.
You go make sure that you check out the Hair Killer, a.k.a. the Hair Doctor, y'all. Hair Healer. She has a bunch of products that are curated for hair growth and hair strength, okay? So make sure that you want to check her out. We only use her products and Shea Moisture. We use her products, my products and her products a lot more than we use the store-bought products. So I'll be talking more about my products a little later. Definitely go and check out the Hair Killer hairline. I'll be posting that below once we repost the video. Again, if you're catching this video in the recap, then make sure that you comment below who you are, where you're tuning in from. Also comment below the different things that you would like to see us, you know, talking about, okay, here on TriVegan TV. We're going to be coming here every Saturday, and when we come here on Saturday to talk to the people, we're going to be telling them about different things that we're cooking and eating, right? And so, you know, if you have something, like I said, that you would like for us to try out, then make sure that you send it to us in our inbox. Make sure that you comment below. Just hit us up. If you have any questions about any products that you see us use, you can ask us, you know, where we got it from. You know, different recipes that we're going to be posting in our stories, in our news feed, different things like that.
Just our overall growth.
Yes, overall growth. Make sure you tune in to what we got going on. And shout out to Eternal Water.
Oh, Eternal.
The number one. You see me? I'm getting an influencer video posted on.
You see
it?
No, it's like this.
I can tell the difference when I'm drinking this. They can't even see the top of your head, sis. but when I'm drinking this, you know, it's times when I drink this. I drink natural spring water majority of the time. And when I'm feeling like I want to detoxify or purifying myself, I'm recalibrating or whatever the case may be, I may go on a week fast with this Eternal Water for its alkaline properties.
I'm sorry, but their website, Roasted Smart Water,
real bad. But it was so professional. Like marketing, good job, Eternal Marketing Team. Okay, so I don't know what I'm gonna cook tonight, y'all.
What time is it? I really do be eating at least one meal a day, and like
that's the idea. That's the idea.
Like I can eat like one meal a day, like the smaller 2 bags hot fries and something to drink, and I'll be set for like.
Okay, well, we're gonna figure it out, and we may post it later, give you guys some ideas. If you know what you're eating tonight, drop it below. Let us know so you can help a mama out. You feel me?
Or we can just come to your house.
Because the mompreneur in me be tired. And it's just that God replenishes me, so I can definitely understand. It is truly a holistic lifestyle over here, y'all. Holistic life and business. And so we encourage you guys to tune in to us. We encourage you to begin to live a healthier lifestyle in your life, and your business, your career as well. Health is wealth, y'all, definitely. And being healthy, wealthy, and wise is the thing to be, okay? So continue to tune in to our page for updates on TriVegan. Tune in every single Saturday here on TriVegan Cafe and on Talking the Streets Entertainment. So you can check out our newest video, okay? And if you want to be a guest, so you can try out our food or whatever we'll be cooking during whatever show it will be, hit us up, because we'll love to have you. We'll love to feed you, okay? But in the meantime, in the in-between time, we encourage you to
try.